May, and as you've probably heard, it's low-code, no-code month in the SAP community. Loads of blogs, discussion, events, tutorials, badges, and all kinds of things. Like Diana's video on what SAP is doing in the low-code, no-code space, and also the new learning journey where you can get certification in low-code, no-code development. All of the content is divided into 4 weeks. So this week is material about introducing the no-code, low-code toolset. Week two is about application development, SAP AppGyver, and SAP Business Application Studio. Week three is about SAP process automation. And week four is about digital experience, which includes SAP WorkZone and Launchpad. I want to highlight two special initiatives. First is my 100 days challenge, where I'll be learning over the course of 100 days the low-code, no-code toolset. And I will tweet and blog about my experiences and hopefully provide you with a learning journey and tips and tricks on how to navigate the toolset. And the second initiative is our no-code challenge. Just build an application with SAP AppGyver. Tell us about your experiences, positive and negative. And you can win a no-code hoodie. I don't even have one, and I've been trying real hard to get one. As always, all of the details are in the description.
Hello, SAP developers. I recently joined the SAP Developer Advocates team. And as part of the team, I will focus on integration topics. For example, APIs, the SAP Integration Suite, and enterprise integration in general. My name is Antonio Maradiaga, and in case you want to get notified of the latest innovations in the SAP integration world, you can find links to my social media profiles in the video's description. And now to some API-related news. In the latest episode of the SAP Integration and Extension Talk podcast, Hannah Salomon talks with Daniel Liu, who is the head of SAP Graph. The goal of SAP Graph is to greatly simplify how we can interact with SAP data in different systems. Have a listen of the podcast episode if you want to learn about what SAP Graph is, what's great about its simplicity, how you can use it now, and how you can make the most of it in your future developments when extending or integrating with SAP systems.
If you are developing data-intensive applications using SAP HANA, then do not miss two interactive SAP community calls scheduled for later this month. First, on May 17th, the product manager Jan Zwickel will give you an update on calculation views modeling in SAP Business Application Studio. The session will highlight some key features of calculation views and will explain how calculation views fit into SAP HANA Cloud development concepts, including the HANA deployment infrastructure or HDI. Then on May 19th, Markus Fass and Umang Kravat from the multi-model development team will help you to gain hands-on experience with SAP HANA Graph. You will learn more about graph models, the graph pattern matching, the graph built-in algorithms, and the graph procedures available in SAP HANA database. So, see you at SAP Community Calls.
React version 18 was released to the public in March 2022 and is all about concurrency. This is a behind-the-scenes update to how React loads the UI, which responds quicker to user input and provides a better experience. Almost all of the new features in this version are related to this change in the core rendering model of React. One of the important new features is the improvement to the suspense component, which now allows for data fetching with other popular front-end frameworks like Next.js. This component may be extended in future releases. There have also been enhancements in the automatic batching of state updates, improving performance. Another addition is the continued development of server components for support for server-side rendering. This feature is still experimental, but will be officially released in a minor version of React 18. So there's good news for all of the SAP front-end developers. There are no breaking changes from the previous two versions of React, and the UI5 web components for React supports version 18 out of the box. You only need to install the new version of React and slightly change how the root component is created to start using the new features. This is not all there is to the latest version of React, as there were also new hooks added and improvements for library authors and other such things. Check out the documentation linked below for more info. Happy coding!
If you enjoy these short SAP developer news videos from the Developer Advocates, then I'm sure you'll also enjoy the new SAP BTP Innobytes video series over on the SAP Technology Channel. These videos are published monthly, and I quote, are fresh, snackable BTP insights that you can consume quickly. What's more, each of the videos in this monthly series is accompanied by a blog post with all the details and links for each of the items. Check out the first in this series, 04 for April, via the link in the blog post from